good versus evil stories are built into my DNA because I was raised Catholic. And so before you even get to comic books, they give you the Bible and like, look at these stories of adventure. Who's a bigger hero than the Son of God, for heaven's sakes? When I was a kid, the first thing I geeked out about was Batman, because I watched Adam West's Batman 66 series every day. Comics came into my life when I would say I was about 5 years old. My father took me for my first haircut at Vinny the Barber's. And before I got my haircut, my dad was getting his haircut, and Vinny the Barber was like, there's comic books under the TV over there if you want to read them and stuff. And there's a stack of comic books. And there they were. There was Batman, there was Spider-Man, all the characters that I'd watched cartoons for, literally in printed form. And that started a lifelong obsession with these characters. Mostly at home is where geekdom begins, because you can watch a thing over and over, and then you meet like-minded individuals who know about that thing as well, and then you create families based and predicated on fictions, for heaven's sakes. And there were no terms for it in the 70s. I was born in 1970. People weren't like, oh, he's a geek, or oh, he's a nerd. You just liked the thing very much, and you became known by that thing. I've always loved stories of derring do. Person least likely who steps up and becomes that person who saves one or all or makes the big difference. And all of the best superhero stories about the same thing. The whole world is running from the worst thing that ever happened. And then there's one individual racing at it. That's a way to live, a code to live by. And He-Man is absolutely no different. He's a superhero. And he's a superhero down to his genetic level, in as much as he has a secret identity. And that appealed to me as a kid when I was watching He-Man and the Masters of the Universe, age 11 and 12. I love the world of heroics, bigger than life characters, loud, gaudy costumes and whatnot, very simple black and white themes of good versus evil. So given the chance to play with those characters as an adult, I always love to do it. I don't do it in the movies because I don't think I'm talented enough to make movies like that. But I've done it in comics for years. I wrote Daredevil, I wrote Green Arrow, I've written Batman. So leaning into that, you know, the affection that I had for that type of storytelling as a kid that stayed with me throughout my entire life. I'm 50 years old and I still get choked up when I see people do the right thing, fictional people. Good versus evil stories are built into my DNA because I was raised Catholic. And so before you even get to comic books, they give you the Bible and like, look at these stories of adventure. I'm very familiar with mythical archetypes and stories of good versus evil and whatnot. So when I discovered comic books and cartoons and superheroes, and I didn't get much morality out of sitting in church for an hour once a week. I got my morality out of watching Batman, out of watching He-Man. It's like these were the characters that instilled in me a better reason to be good. Other than like, you're gonna go to hell if you're not good, kid. And that led to like what I became. I didn't become a hero, but I started making choices that others don't make because of the things that I watched. And it led to me being like a filmmaker, which is a dream job for me. Kids, I've been in this game now going on 27 years. Early on, I just kind of put geek culture, comic book culture into everything I did. If you go watch Mallrats, second movie I ever made, Stan Lee's in it, for heaven's sakes.
Holy shit! Aren't you?
Oh, Stanley. Hi.
I put into my movies the things that made me happy in life. I've watched geekdom glow up, if you will, from something that, like, you know, I remember when we did Mallrats, people were like, who's Stan Lee? To now, everybody knows who Stan Lee is. Your mom knows who Stan Lee is, because pop culture shifted and became the culture. You'd get beat up for telling people you like comic books back in the day. Now, they pay you millions of dollars. Those cartoons, man, and those characters informed me throughout most of my life. I just felt like as I brought them into the present, if I could give a little of that back to the audience, to be able to give it like a gift and be like, this is what made me who I am. I hope you like it too. And that's how we find out, in many ways, who our parents are. I was a kid sitting there next to my dad, watching him watch Raiders of the Lost Ark excitedly. And he would tell me very excitedly, this is the kind of movie I grew up watching. That was a moment for me. Watching your parents watch things that mean something to them is an important legacy that we hand down generation to generation. And I've had that same experience with my wife and Masters of the Universe Revelation. Because she was like, oh, I remember this cartoon. And I was like, wait till you see what we did. And she was blown away by like the story actors. She was like, this is the first time I could watch a cartoon like this and enjoy it. Nothing I do speaks to my wife, nothing. So the idea of this, of all things, Masters of the Universe Revelation, speaking to her, thank God I got to have that in my lifetime. Otherwise, what would me and my wife talk about?